Hello everyone, welcome back to Mufasuket with Inventor 3D modeling, how to make a vertical flange bearing. And you can get this reference image from our site mufasuket.com. Okay, we start now. Open your Inventor software and click start to sketch. I will choose this plane. First, we create a line object from this point to the left. Okay, to the bottom here, and I will go to the right. Move to the top and to this point. Right click and OK. Next, use dimension. We give dimension for this line object 41. OK. And then you can zoom out. I will give a dimension for this line object 402. Next, we give a dimension for this line object 86, and this line object 86. Okay, use a circle command to create a circle. Okay, start from this point with a diameter 230. Okay, circle again with diameter 210. We create a circle with a diameter 180. Okay, create again 152. Okay, we create a 100 here. And then the last 72. Okay. Next, use dimension. We give a distance from this center point to this point. Okay, 125. Okay, create a line object. Start from this point to this point. From this point to this point. Okay, and another set in here. And then from this point to this point. Okay, you can use a trim command to cut this circle object and then this line object. Now we already create this simple 2D sketch, and then I will extrude this object. You can click 3D model tab, click extrude command. Okay, I will extrude this face. Okay, you can select this face. We extrude with arrows. Okay, you can change arrows into this direction. And then give 10 millimeters. Okay, you can click in here. And then right click in sketch 1. Click share sketch. Okay, I will click sketch 1. And then use extrude command again to extrude this face 115. Okay, and then we extrude this face 105. Okay, extrude again this face 100. Okay, extrude this face 102. And last, we extrude this face 115. Okay, we already create this 3D models. Next, you can select this face, and then we create a circle object. Okay, I will create circle in here with diameter 50. Okay, we create again in here with diameter 50. Give distance, use dimension command, select this circle and then select this object. Okay, in here 41. Okay, and then we give distance in here 41. Okay, use extrude command. I will cut this object with this two circle. Okay, move arrows to the bottom, and then you can click OK to cut this object. Next, I will hide the sketch one. You can right click here and then click visibility. I will use a fillet command. Okay, with radius 3, you can select this edge. Okay, I will select this edge. You can select one by one. Okay, in here. Okay, I will select this point in here. Okay. And then in here. Select here. Okay, we'll select in here. In here. Can select one by one. And the last this edge. Okay. Click apply to apply a fillet command. And then you can cancel to close this comment. Okay, we create this simple 3D models. Next, I will give material into this object. You can click tools here. Next, click appearance. Okay, I will use Autodesk appearance material. I will click metal here and click steel. Okay, I will use satin material. Okay, I will use satin hammer. This material, you can select object. Okay, I will select this extrusion, and in here you can right click in this material, assign to selection. I will edit this material. Okay, into I will unselect relief pattern here, and you can close. Sorry, I will cancel and apply, close. Next, I will use plastic material. Okay, I will use this material. You can select this extrusion, right click assign to selection, and then for red material. You can select this extrusion 3, 2, 1 and then 7 and pilot. Okay, I will apply this material high class, right click assign to selection. Okay, next you can select this edge, and in here I will apply this material, right click and assign to selection. Okay, we already create this simple 3D object, vertical flange bearing. And then so I will try to rendering this object. You can active full shadow, you can click view here and then click shadow. Okay, for reflection, I will settings. Reflection into this point, okay, blur into this point, and then blur fall off in here. You can apply and close. Next, go to the environment here, click Inventor Studio. Okay, for studio lightning styles, I will active sharp highlight. You can click active here. Okay, and then check display scan image. Next, I will rotate. Okay, to get the best view for environment. Okay, it is enough. Next, you can save. Then, I will try to rendering this object. You can click here for rendering duration. I will use render by iteration into 32, or you can use this option until satisfactory. Okay, for lighting and material, I will use height, and I will try to render this object. You can click here to render. We finish rendering process, and I think it's enough today for Inventor 3D modeling how to make a vertical flange bearing. If you have any question about this tutorial, you can comment below this video. And see you next time in another Inventor 3D modeling tutorial.